Hey guys, hey, I wanted to address an issue that you might be dealing with yourself if you've been thinking about making a move in this really, really hot market. And that is the idea and the fear of potentially being homeless. You know, when market is red hot and there's a ton of buyer activity and you're thinking, gosh, you know what? I know I could put my house on the market and probably sell quickly, but what's the point? I got to live somewhere. And the whole issue of me making this move is finding something that I want to purchase. Do I put my house up for sale and potentially end up being homeless and not finding that house? Or do I run along, find that house I want to purchase, and now somehow try and compete knowing that I'm going to be contingent? And that's going to make my purchasing that house so much more difficult, especially when things are so competitive. So what do you do in a situation like that? Well, there's a couple of things you can look at that are beyond just the maybe just find intermediate housing. And that is still an option. I mean, you could certainly look at something like an intermediate rental, or you could look at moving in with a friend or family member for a period of time as a worst case scenario. But there's a couple of other options I just wanted to present that might make it a little bit easier to put yourself out there and get that house potentially sold and find that one without overstretching yourself. So the first one we're going to talk about is something called a seller rent back. A seller rent back is a situation where a buyer comes in, they write a purchase agreement, you close on the house, and then you get to continue to live in the property for a pre-negotiated period of time. It could be for a number of weeks, it could be for a couple of months. Now, there are limitations as to how far this can go, so don't just think that any buyer can come through and just give you as long as you want. But it certainly can give time where maybe instead of just having that short, you know, 1 to 2 month window that you needed to find something and get into it, maybe you're going to give yourself a few extra months and you're going to be able to make that move. Now, while that in itself is positive, there is still risk with something like a seller rent back, which is it still is going to have an end date towards it. And so that end date may create the same scenario we were trying to avoid in the first place. Sure, you've got more time, but you could still be in a situation where you had overstretched and now you're not quite sure where you're going to move into. And this is what is keeping a lot of people from even moving forward with certain steps to make that move, which brings up a second option and one I think is far more favorable. And that is the idea of doing a reverse contingency. A reverse contingency is where you agree to sell your house to a buyer, but you put a very clear stipulation into it that says that you as the seller can cancel that agreement with the buyer at any time if you don't enter into a purchase agreement for a home you want to purchase over the next period of weeks. A lot of buyers are cool with this. They say, you know what? The market is so competitive right now, we'll give you time to go through and find it. And at the same time, you don't overleverage yourself because you always have, and you are always in control of when you decide to exercise that cancellation. So you sell that property, you begin looking as a non-contingent buyer in this situation. If you go those 2 or 3 weeks and you're just not finding what you're looking for, or you weren't able to compete and get into that property at the price you were hoping to do so, you can go back to that buyer and say, do you want to renegotiate how long I have to look? Or I've decided we're just gonna cancel. Now in this situation, the buyer's always gonna get their earnest money back, so the risk is pretty much muted. It also means that there are other issues to deal with in terms of when the inspection is done and how those factors might come into it. But the idea of reverse contingency can still give you a lot of options. And that's why I wanted to share with you today. If you have any questions on reverse contingencies or seller rentbacks or anything to do with the market, feel free to reach out and I'd love to chat with you. Have a great day.